हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू नितवेद बायोसाइंस। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसपोर्ट चेन। ओके, अप टिल नाउ वी हैड सीन दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसपोर्ट चेन कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर कॉम्प्लेक्सेस। ओके, लेट्स सी इन अ वेरी शॉर्टली व्हाट विल हैपन इन द ऑल दिस फोर कॉम्प्लेक्सेस। ओके, सो कॉम्प्लेक्स वन विल एक्ट एज अ एक्सेप्टर फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम NADH। ओके, What is actually the electron transport chain? Here, the complexes will accept the electrons from NADH and FADH2, which are generating during the various catabolic process. Okay, after accepting the electrons, these electrons will move to the various component which are arranged in the increasing order of their redox potential, or we can say that the energy level. Means they are decreasing in the they are arranged in the decreasing order of their energy level. Okay, so what will happen during the transfer of these electrons? Some sort of free energy will be available, and that energy will be available to pump the proton from matrix to intermembrane space. And when this proton will come back from the complex fifth, which is not the part of electron transport chain. Okay, we have to be very careful here. So when these protons will again come back to matrix regions, it will help in generating the ATP. Okay, so right now we are just focusing on the electron transport chain, which is consist of the four complexes. Okay, so complex one will accept the electrons from NADH, complex two will accept the electron from FADH2, and then both will transfer to coenzyme Q, which is a lipid soluble molecule which present in the inner mitochondrial membrane. So that is act as a shuttle system. Okay, so with the help of coenzyme Q, when the coenzyme Q will accept the electron, coenzyme Q is known as a ubiquinone, and when it will accept the electron, it will convert it into ubiquinol. Okay, so that ubiquinol will transfer the electron to complex 3. Okay, both NADH and FADH2 will transfer the two electrons. Okay, so ubiquinol have the two electrons. Clear up to this? Then from complex 3 to complex 4, and finally that electron will reach to oxygen. Okay, so oxygen will act as a final acceptor of electrons, and that with combining with the two proton molecule will generate the water molecule. Okay, so starting is the NADH and FADH2, and final is the oxygen. Clear up to this? Okay, so to know the more detail about all these things, you can watch my previous video of electron transport chain part 2. Okay, right now we will discuss the Q cycle. Okay, so what is Q cycle? Before that, we'll repeat again here. Okay, see, these are protein complex 1, complex 2, then both will transfer the electron to mobile element, that is a coenzyme Q, and that coenzyme Q act as a shuttle vehicle. It will accept the electron from these two complex and will come to complex 3. Okay, complex 3, and then another shuttle vehicle is there, that is cytochrome C, and cytochrome C will transfer to complex 4. Okay, so here, when the electrons will move from complex 1 or in the complex 2, that is a single step reaction or single step process. But here in the complex 3, it is a two step. So we'll see why it requires a two step reaction, and that two step process is known as a Q cycle. So we'll focus here. Q cycle takes place in the complex 3. Okay, Q cycle in the complex 3. So we'll just focus here on the complex 3. Okay, so when coenzyme Q will accept the two electrons and with the two proton, the compound form is known as a ubiquinol. Ubiquinol. See how we write the name of the enzyme complex that we had discussed. The compound which is oxidizing will write its name first, and the compound which is reducing will write its name second. So the complex third, or the third complex name is the cytochrome B7 complex, or it is also known as a ubiquinol cytochrome C oxidoreductase. Okay, so suppose this is a complex 3 here. Ubiquinol is there and here cytochrome C is there. Okay, and then it will finally transfer it to complex 4. Now the problem is that this ubiquinol, okay, the reduced form of the coenzyme Q has a 2 electrons, and this cytochrome C, which is the second shuttle system, it will transfer the electron from complex 3 to 4. It can transfer only the one electron at a time. Again, I am repeating, ubiquinol has a 2 electrons. It will transfer the 2 electrons, but the cytochrome C, it will transfer only the one electron at a time. So what would be the solutions? You only think, what would be the solutions? We'll transfer the electron one by one, right? First we'll transfer the one electron, and second, then we'll transfer the second electron. Yeah, so therefore the first half of the cycle will transfer the one electron, second half will transfer the second electron, and together it is known as a Q cycle. Therefore Q cycle has a two half cycle, or the two mini cycle, which will transfer the one electron at a time from coenzyme Q or ubiquinol to cytochrome C. Clear? One electron at a time. So we'll talk about this Q cycle. Okay, today's our topic of discussion is a Q cycle, which is present in a complex 3 and which is very, very important for the exam point of view or MCQ point of view. Okay, so we'll draw the structure here. Okay, before that, one more thing we'll discuss here. See, we know that there are 4 complexes of electron transport chain, right? Yeah, and we all know that when the electron will move, okay, so from complex 1, it will transfer the 4 proton, complex 2, no proton, complex 3, again 4 proton, and complex 4, 2 proton will be pumped from matrix to intermembrane space. Okay, so what is happening here in a complex 3, 4 protons will be pumped from matrix to intermembrane space. But as this Q cycle has a 2 half cycle, so first 2 proton will be pumped in the first half, and then 2 proton will be pumped from in a second half. Okay, this is a 2 step reaction. Q cycle is a 2 step. So first 2 proton will pumped. Okay, and then in the second half cycle or second mini cycle, 2 protons. So together in this way, complex 3 will pump the 4 proton from matrix to intermembrane space. But here this 2 proton in the complex 4, that will be pumped in a single step, and here also in the complex 1, the 4 proton will be pumped in a single step. But this complex 3 required a 2 step reaction. Okay, so let us start the Q cycle. Suppose this is a complex 3. So we will write 2 cycles separately to avoid confusion. Okay. Here we will write the step 1. What will happen in the step 1, and here we will write the step 2 of Q cycle. What we are discussing here, Q cycle. Okay. So the first electron will come from QH2. QH2 means the ubiquinol, or it is a reduced form of the coenzyme Q. When this reduced form of coenzyme Q will convert to quinone. Okay, when it will convert to quinone, that means it will be oxidized. It will donate its two electrons and two protons. Right? So we'll talk here only about the electrons. First, these electrons will be accepted by iron sulfur center of complex 3, which is also known as a risky protein or risky center. This is also, we need to remember for risky protein or risky center. This we need to remember for MCQ. Risky protein or risky center. The iron sulfur cluster of complex 3 is known as a risky protein or risky center. Okay. So first, the electron will come to iron sulfur cluster, and from iron sulfur cluster to cytochrome C1, and from then cytochrome C. But as I had already mentioned, here only the one electron will be transferred at a time. So here we'll write one electron. Suppose one electron here, and the second electron will be transferred to cytochrome B. Okay, so the two electrons from ubiquinol will follow the two path. First path, the electron will be accepted by iron sulfur cluster, from iron sulfur cluster to cytochrome C1, and from cytochrome C1 to cytochrome C. Right? And the cytochrome C, it is actually the water soluble. So it is present outside the inner membrane. See, inner membrane has a lipid bilayer. So cytochrome C will present the outside the inner membrane in the intermembrane space, and from there, after accepting the one electron, it will transfer to complex 4. Yeah, so from here, the cytochrome C will transfer electron to complex 4. And what is about the another electron? From cytochrome P, we cannot leave this electron like that, because these are the high energy electrons. If we leave the electron like that, it will lose its energy in the form of heat. Okay, so we need to be, means the nature is such a protective way, it will take care of everything. So from cytochrome B, now after donating this electron here, this Q will transfer to another active site. It is the same coenzyme Q. Okay, after donating its two electrons, like it is throwing and again coming for the catch. One electron has gone to cytochrome C, and to catch the another electron, because we need to protect another electron. So to catch that another electron, it will same come to another active site, and that another electron will transfer to coenzyme Q, and after accepting the one electron, this will convert to semiquinol. Okay, two electron, so ubiquinol having the two electrons, ubiquinol no electrons, ubiquinone and having the one electron is semiquinol. Clear up to this? So again I am repeating, after donating the two electrons, ubiquinol will convert to ubiquinone, and two electrons will have the two different pathway. In the one pathway, it is accepted by iron sulfur cluster of complex 3, which is also known as a risky protein, from risky group to cytochrome C1 and then to cytochrome C. Okay, because as it transfer only the one electron at a time, so second electron will come to again to Q via the cytochrome B, and after accepting the one electron, we'll put here the one negative charge on the Q, okay, because it is having the one electron. So it is known as a semiquinol. Okay, now we can consider that this get electrons are transferring to cytochrome C, but this get allow only the entry of QH2 having the two electron, but here we are having the one electron. So what we need to do? So here another ubiquinol will come. Okay, this is a one ubiquinol. We'll write it with a star mark. So this is another second molecule of ubiquinol will come. When the second molecule will come, it will again follow the same path. Okay, till the time this will present here in the complex. Okay, this will here only. So suppose we'll write here, like, so if we write, suppose this is a one, so this is the second. Okay, so first this semiquinol is already there from the first ubiquinol molecules, and now this second ubiquinol has come. So again it will follow the same path. Two electrons will come, one follow the this pathway, another follow the this pathway. So again same thing will happen. It will transfer its electron in the two way, the first iron sulfur cluster, then cytochrome C1 and two cytochrome C, and again cytochrome B second electron will come to here. But this semiquinol already, it has a one electron already there from the first step. Second electron will come. Okay, so after accepting the two electrons, two protons from the matrix, so after accepting the two electrons, two protons, this will convert to QH2 after accepting the two electrons, because already one electron it is having, second electron will come and plus 2H positive ions, so it will convert to ubiquinol. Now this ubiquinol will again enter into the cycle. So this is all about the Q cycle. Okay, there is nothing like a tricky things, just we need to remember few things. Ubiquinol has a two electrons and cytochrome C can transfer the one electron at a time. Therefore, to transfer the both the electrons, it will require the two step. Okay, so this two step collectively it is known as a Q cycle. Okay, coenzyme Q having the two electron and the two hydrogen, it is known as a ubiquinol. When it will donate its two electron, it will convert to ubiquinone. This two electron will have the two path. The first electron will follow this path, another electron will follow the this path. So first electron will transfer to iron sulfur cluster, from iron sulfur to cytochrome C1, and from cytochrome C1 to cytochrome C, and this will transfer its one electron. Okay, again it will come back to take another molecule. So for that, another second ubiquinol will come. Out of two electrons, first will follow the same path. Another electron will come here, and this semiquinol, which is already having the one electrons, when the second electron will come, this will convert to ubiquinone, and this again will enter into the cycle. Okay, this is all a Q cycles, and during the transfer of the one electron from this path, it will pump the two hydrogen ion here. In the second step also, two hydrogen, two proton, therefore collectively the complex 3 will form the, it will pump 2 plus 2, that is 4 proton from matrix to intermembrane space. Okay, so this is all about the Q cycle, which is present in the complex 3. Okay, in the next class we'll talk about the complex 5, that is ATP synthesis. Okay, thank you.